Thanks everyone for your presence. I am thankful to PK for arranging this session. And for his guidance to me how to conduct a session. I joined HC some 10 weeks back. That is when I got my first iPad. I downloaded SC and started working on it. I must say it is an extraordinary software. Apart from the technical excellence, what appeals to me is the presentation of the gallery and the total transparency of the system. We are conducting this session because of the auto with I must compliment the BP for this excellent software. I have posted only few of my works. And method of approach of mine has caused some curiosity. Coming to our topic for discussion, that is grid. I may say it is an old system. Used mainly for getting the right proportion from a reference picture. But for digital art, it is not an absolute necessity because the size of the image is small enough. It doesn't warrant an elaborate grid for that. But I use the grid for a different purpose. since the size of the screen is very small and the image is larger, normally we zoom the picture while drawing. And I sometimes get confused about the position where I am drawing. So the lines of the grid helps me in identifying the portion on which I am working. I believe everyone will be zooming the picture for drawing details. Before coming to the construction of the grid, I shall explain the setup I am having here. Normally I work with a reference. Which I project it on my laptop. It is in front of me. There will be grid projected there. Then on my iPad, for this demo, I have used the standard size, because I didn't want a large canvas. After pressing new, I am now ready to construct the grid. Before that, I want to tell you, we can have grid in two different ways. Earlier, I used in Photoshop a screenshot of it. And crop it to the required size and resolution and save it in my iPad. And I used to image load this blank canvas and prepare the picture. The main disadvantage is it causes an image load which may cause some suspicion. Luckily for me, Kabbos came up with an interesting method of preparing the grid. In this, what you do is, you use pixel to get the grid lines. This is how it is done. In brush, you go to select pixel. Select the size to the maximum 128 and set inset at maybe 1% or 2% and 3D0. This will be the pixel size. Now, when I do a picture, I normally work on a colored canvas, and the color is determined by the color of the picture. For this reference, I have used a golden brown as the background. So that will be the color of the pixel. What I do is, I draw the stylus over the canvas, and you will notice the formation of the grid lines. Sorry, this is not the color I want. Do you see the lines now? This is a grid, 8 squares across and 6 vertical. Normally, I don't need so many squares. I will erase those lines to reduce the number of blocks. I am erasing the line in between so that I will get only 4 squares across and 3 squares vertical. You will see that I have reduced the number of blocks and I have rubbed off the lines, because I really do not like lines. I need only the cross section at the corners. Now the canvas is ready for sketching, and I will start with the top left hand block. I must tell you one thing, that I always set my brush tip at 1 pixel, that's the smallest size. One thing I didn't mention is that I always work from dark to light. system crashed, I have to recover the canvas. I am beginning the sketch. First thing I do is to create the middle tone. Before I go to the next block, I will show you how I finish this half-tone portion I have already done. Are you able to see the sketch? I will be frequently rotating the canvas. You would have noticed that I have removed the brown color from the middle portion of the white. If I don't do that, the lines in between the hairs will be shown as dark brown, whereas actually it is a light gray. Here the direction of the stroke is very important for creating fur. I will now move down to the next block where the I is there. I have indicated the eye now, and I will be now shading the surrounding areas. Here I will pause for a moment and ask you whether you have any questions to ask. Have you any question on the preparation of a grid? Yes, many of you may be wondering why I'm doing hair by hair. I can only tell you that I can attribute it to my background. I am a scratchboard artist. And we normally work from dark to light. And since it is a type of engraving, we use sharp needles or X-acto blades and draw the hairs. I am following the same technique here, and I think it is effective. Now I shall proceed. Now it is 15 minutes. Do we take a break here and resume after 5 or 10 minutes? I was telling you about the other type of grid which requires image load. It has got certain advantages over the other one because it is flexible. You can have the required number of squares, resolution, size. But the main disadvantage, as I said, was it causes an image load. What do you think? It takes only a few seconds. When I am following the pixel method, I don't save the grid. I prepare then and there. I think I used my method, the earlier one, where I had a blank canvas with a grid drawn on it. I have taken a screenshot and cropped it. That is why I am wiping off the lines to reduce the number of squares. I think the best number of squares would be 4 by 3 or at the most 6 by 4 or whatever. For my reference, it is on the PC, and Photoshop has the facility to create a grid. The retina will create 12 by 16. Somehow, I don't feel comfortable working with layers. My lack of knowledge, perhaps. Someday I should try that. I don't know anything about the other method of creating grids. I said that I use my earlier method for Hitchcock, that is creating a grid in Photoshop and transferring it to iPad. If you are working on a white canvas, what I would suggest is first fill the canvas with a gray color, light gray color, and draw the pixels using white color. So you will get light gray grid lines. When I did Hitchcock, I was not aware of the pixel method. Time is up, I shall resume now. Now I shall start working on the nose. I think we will see. I think it is getting late. People would be wanting to get back to sleep. I will have to fine-tune this and finish the remaining part, and the final version I shall post. Any more questions? I feel happy if some of you are benefited with this demo. I have no idea what it is going to be like.